Have you ever heard of the Christmas story?
The one about Santa that you told me like 300 times today?
Yeah, I've been explaining a lot because today's Christmas Eve, right?
Yep.
So Santa comes with his reindeer from the North Pole. Boo-doo-doo-doo-doo. Our house is right here, okay? He comes to the chimney and gives us our presents.
Okay, I thought about that all day because you've been telling me this story. We don't have a chimney.
Okay, well the next thing he would do, if that did happen to arise, is he would bring his reindeer down to the street. Then he'd walk up with his presents, go through our door, probably knock, and give us our presents.
It's not the one Mom told us.
Oh, well, what is exactly the one Mom told you?
The one about baby Jesus being born.
Oh, well, here's the thing, Thomas. All right, here's the thing. This right here is my story, okay? Not Mom's story. If you really have a big deal about it, you can go to Mom's house and get her story from her, okay? Mm-hmm. Right?
I don't think he knows where Mom's house is.
Oh. Well, ever since your mom left us, I've been really trying to, like, help you guys out and give you guys as much love and kindness that I can. Right?
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Yeah.
Give me a hug.
I love you, Dad.
I love you, too.
So, do you like the Christmas story?
Yeah, I love it.
Oh, there's someone at the door.
Oh, but wait, make sure he brings a dirt bike tonight.
Oh, yeah, what if it's Santa?
Yeah.
Hello?
Back door.
Okay.
Right now.
Okay.
Who's it, Dad?
I know.
Is it Santa, Dad? Is it Santa? Is it Santa? Is it
okay,
Santa?
Here's the thing, okay? It's a surprise.
Okay.
He might be here, he might not, but I really need you guys to stay here, all right? I'm going to the back door. I'll be gone for only a couple minutes, right? Why the heck are you guys here on Christmas Eve? Like, why are you guys even here? Why? What do you want?
Never told me you have a child.
So what if I have a child?
You know it's against the rules to start a family, right, Silas?
I know my place in this world!
You should be grateful that I let you run away with that cute girl.
I did not tell anybody about what we did or who you guys are.
Mary did.
What does that have to do with Mary?
We came over to her house. Let's just say we didn't wish her a Merry Christmas. Get the bastard! Kill him! Get him! I told you not to F with me! Go! Go!
How many roads must a man walk down before before you call him a man. How many seas must the white dove sail before she sleeps in the sand? How many times must the cannonballs fly before they're forever banned? The answer, my friend, is blowing in the wind. The answer is blowing in the wind. How many years can a mountain exist before it's washed to the sea? How many years can some people exist before they're allowed to be free? How many times can a man turn his head and pretend that he just doesn't see? The answer, my friend, is blowing in the wind. The answer is blowing in the wind. How many times must a man look up before he really sees the sky? How many ears must one person have before he can hear people cry? How many deaths will it take till he knows that too many people have died? The answer, my friend, is blowing in the wind. The answer is blowing in the wind. The answer, my friend, is blowing in the wind. The answer is.
He said he'd meet me here. Where is he?
Turn around!
You didn't.
Get up! What are you gonna do?
Nothing.
What are you gonna do?
Nothing!
You're gonna turn around, and you're not gonna come back. I don't want to see your face again. Get up!
Like your dad.
Yeah.
Why don't we go to your house now? It's all ready to go.
Okay. Might as well get it over with.
Lincoln, I hope you enjoy the place. As you can see, we installed in the autumn decorations, and even though it's Christmas, that's besides the point. Well, welcome back.
Yeah, well,
hope you.
You don't have to act professional with me. It's been 16 years.
Yeah, well, would you like to have a seat?
Sure. So, all the things been in town, are they still the same as when I left?
Oh man, yeah. There's criminals going around, people raping other people, and it's just terrible. You know, so many people that need Jesus. That pretty much sums it up.
Mm-hmm. Someone needs to put a stop to it.
Oh, well. You know, maybe you could come to church tomorrow. I think it would really do some good. It's pretty much the same building, and we've grown a lot in the community.
Well, I thank you for the offer, but I'm afraid I'll have to decline.
Well, listen, Dylan, I really want you to go to church. I'm your friend. I think it'd be really good for you to go to church and clear all those negative thoughts out of your mind and just go back to church. I think it would really do you a service.
Roman, I left the faith years ago. You know this. I can't worship a God who let a little boy's family die. Why can't you accept this?
Dylan, I don't want to get into a theological debate with you. Going to church would definitely lift your spirit and may be able to answer some of the questions you have.
Again, I appreciate the offer, but I'm going to have to say no.
Oh, well. I gotta go. Well, we've been friends for a long time. Really long time. I don't want our friendship to end. Still friends?
That's your choice.
Oh, alright. Well, see you, bud.
Thank you, Ava, for that weather report. Now for what all I know all you listeners have been waiting for. Aiden Atwater, the acclaimed author of the best-selling book, Black Jackets, a local myth, was reportedly found dead this morning. We don't know the cause of death at this moment, but people are already jumping in hysteria by thinking that the Black Jackets are behind this tragedy. Okay, let me get this straight. We have no evidence of the Black Jackets existing. We do, however, have an increasingly dangerous crime rate, and it's been rising up for more and more over the past 10 years. This, however, has nothing to do with the Black Jackets. This is Corey Nash. Horrible crime wave here, but is it coming from a singular mob? Of course not. That's ridiculous. This isn't a James Cagney flick. No gangsters running this city. It's just bad people. Now where the wickedness comes from, only God can answer that question. But it's for sure no century-long mythical gang. Get real, people.
A lot of good people out there, but they're not men. I've seen a lot of men out there, but they're not good men. You gotta not let people undermine you. You gotta fight for what's right. You gotta be a hero.
No! Help me! No! Please, no! 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 Help me! Leave me alone! No! Help! Help! No! No!
So until you can show me those things, you can't go on the sailboat. But if you show me those things, I can guarantee that I will get the sailboat and we will
try to get to Brazil, all right?
Gotta learn to defend yourself. Alright, we'll go back home. How's your eye look? And nothing that won't heal. Let's go, come on.
Problem, the deal shacked up.
What happened?
Reggie and his brothers, they were trying to get the cocaine from Stan. He wouldn't give it to them, and so they...
Get to the point.
One of Reggie's brothers had to pull out a hammer, and then some freaking kid mucked the whole thing. He mucked the whole thing up!
A kid?
Some guy in a hoodie! Freaking
a kid or a guy? How old?
He didn't look that old. He had a mask on. I couldn't freaking tell.
I'll talk to the boss when he gets back.
You better!
I can't have you ruining our family with drugs. If it wasn't for you, this wouldn't happen in the first place.
Okay.
So, if I have any more drug problems with you again, I'll chop you up into pieces, cook it, and feed you to your dogs.
Okay, I get the picture.
Doesn't sound like fun, does it?
No, it doesn't.
Reportedly, as of this morning, two children were kidnapped from the pregnant mother, who was murdered in the process. She was found dead in her car down on 101. We don't know where the children are, but if you have any knowledge of them, please turn it in to the police. We can't trust them. Don't worry.
Dylan, how are you doing? Well, hey, I was wondering, tomorrow at 4:00 in the afternoon, I have a date with my girlfriend, Anne. I was wondering if you wanted to tag along. You have a job interview? Don't you know that all the things here, all the businesses close down at 3? Oh, okay. All right. Well, see you, man.
We'll be right back. Searcher 1, we're dead. Our third guest of the night will be the author of Missing 411, David Pilates, and there's some way cool material there itself. And then we'll end the night, of course, with Rogue Scholar John Hogg, as you were just saying. So we'll do some interviews, George. You'll sing a few songs. It's a great, fun atmosphere. People learn a lot of info about after the show. So it's really cool. We'll do a special tribute to veterans and servicemen. It's a packed night. Tickets are flying out the door.
It's a miracle, everyone. Truly a miracle. The two missing children, Thomas and Hosea Cafferty, have been found outside the local police station. They don't have any recollection of how they got there, but with how starved and thirsty they were, this could only mean two things. The one responsible felt guilty and brought them back, or two, we have a hero in our midst. They didn't just walk over by themselves. If the second option is this case, us as a city have one thing to say to this mystery person. Thank you. Jackets actually real? Now reports show police discovered unconscious criminals all wearing uniforms resembling the local myth. But an even more interesting question is, who is stopping these men? And what do they want?
Jacket beating up our family.
I'm aware. He's not one of ours.
What do you want us to do about it?
Follow him and kill him. If you get the chance, also get me his jacket.
Yes, boss.
One more thing. Was it Silas's jacket?
Greed's?
Yes.
I was too young to remember what it looked like.
Well, after you kill him, check if it's a blonde kid. If it is, then we screwed up big time.
How did we screw up big time, boss?
I don't know. You didn't happen to see another kid that night, did you?
No.
You're 100% sure of that?
Yes, boss.
Okay, I trust you. I know you wouldn't lie to me, son. You can go now. And tell Snake Eyes to lay off on the angel dust.
Okay.
To my band performance. It's coming up soon. I think you'd really enjoy it. What do you say, man?
I'll think about it.
Oh, come on. It'll be fun. You should come, man. We'll have lots of fun with the snacks and, I don't know, maybe do some fun. I don't know. You should definitely come.
Okay. Okay, I'll be there.
Oh, yay. That's great. I'm so excited. I can't wait for you to be there. Well, I gotta go, man. I gotta...
All right, bye.
I should really get him a gift.
Just like the ones I used to know.
That'll do.
Where the treetops glisten and children. Thank you.
What am I doing?
What do you want?
Hey, John, I saw you at my house. What is that smell? It smells like alcohol. Oh, never mind. I saw you at my house yesterday. Is there anything you need?
Couldn't you have just called me on the phone?
Well, Dylan, I know you have no way to chat with. I thought I could come over and chat.
I don't need people to chat with. Well, might as well come in.
All right. Take my shoes off, don't mind. Well, I know you don't need anyone to chat with, but for a lack of a better word, I would say our conversation last time was unfulfilling. We used to be friends.
We were just kids, Roman. Friendships fall apart all the time.
Dylan, I don't want our friendship to fall apart. Now, I know I'm beating a dead horse here, but I really want you to come to church this Sunday. Me and those other people will welcome you there with open arms.
Enough with all this Jesus Bible crap. Now get out of my house!
Dylan, please. Those people love you, and they want you back. Dylan, whatever happened to that little Christ-filled boy?
He grew up. I don't want anything to do with any sort of God.
Don't say stuff you don't mean, Dylan.
I mean every single word.
Dylan, I'm never giving up on you, and God will never give up on you.
Get out!
No, Dylan, I won't leave. I won't be like your dad.
What'd you just say?
Sorry, I should have said that.
No, what do you mean?
Do you know what your dad did to your family? Do you remember it?
Silas Creed was a great man. My mother left him.
She left him!
Dylan, your dad, he killed your brother, Thomas, and then he killed himself.
No, that's not true.
I know you try to bury these thoughts, but they're true, Dylan.
My father and brother were murdered by the Black Jackets. Because he was indebted to them.
Dylan, I'm sorry to tell you, but there's no evidence that these Black Jackets exist that you blame for ruining your life. Dylan, it's like you were putting your father on a pedestal. And when you put humans on pedestals, they'll always disappoint you. You're worshiping the wrong person, and you know it.
I'm not going to be like all you other good people in this town doing nothing, not standing up for what is right. These Black Jackets have been terrorizing this city for longer than I can remember. It's time I stood up.
What? The Black Jackets? You're talking like you've seen them. You've seen them? How could you have seen them? Dear Lord, you're the walker, aren't you? Dylan, there's this vigilante who has been going around town and beating up people. He wears his hood, and the police are chasing after him like hounds. They're calling you the walker.
Maybe I am the walker. I'm not going to quit just from a few silly words from you.
But Dylan, this is illegal, and you're lucky I'm not calling the cops. You know what?
Go ahead. I'll take them all on.
What are you going to do? Just put on your hood and your mask? Kill them all? Who are you trying to protect here? Why do you even wear a mask? What are you doing?
I'll do whatever it takes.
I need to kill the Black Jackets because they murdered my family.
But Dylan, even if the Black Jackets exist, how are you going to take them all on if they're dangerous as you claim they are? How are you going to do that? Why don't they... They're just going to come over and kill you.
It's a chance I'm willing to take.
Dylan, if you keep heading down this path, you'll be no better than just the Black Jackets themselves. You need to change.
What would be a good change, Roman?
A good change would be when you come to church with no hood, no mask, with a smile on your face. That's when I know that you've changed.
That's never gonna happen.
You know what? Come to church, Dylan. Take the address.
Take back your stupid card and get out. If you have my best interest in your mind, get out of my house.
Dylan.
What are you doing? I don't need you. I don't need God. I don't need a woman. Now get out!
Married.
Christmas.
Very well, Dylan. I'll be praying for you. Only God himself can help you at this point.
I'd like to see him try.
All right, Dylan. You have my phone number. You can call me whenever. And I'm gonna leave this address for you for church one last time. Bye, Dylan.
This kid is really making my life look like a living hell, while also making me feel some self-worth.
That makes no sense.
I haven't felt this excitement since you brought that one hooker in here, Snake Eyes. This is a different kind of excitement. I feel challenged. Like someone could actually face me without cowering out.
I recommend you be careful, boss.
Don't be such a pecker, Cole. I've never felt so alive. Not after that night Silas challenged me. And if I'm right, which I always am, this mysterious person beating up our men is Silas's son.
Which means you aren't always right because you let the little brat get away 15 some years ago.
Easy, Cole. He's right. We messed up last time. This time we're not going to. But first, I want to toy with him. Maybe killing his church-going friend would really piss him off.
Not as bad as this will. Trust me, it's a real sob story.
Whatever it is you want, sir. I just think that...
Cole, my boy, why do you doubt me? You've never doubted me since I took care of you after your mother abandoned you. And I cared for you when my old man didn't with me.
Now cut me some slack and get in line with the rest of the family!
Yes, boss.
Yes, yes. Yes, boss.
Now, leave me to myself.
Sure you don't want to get anything, boss?
I'm sure.
Alright.
Don't F with me, kid.
Thank you.
this is another Mormon or even Jehovah's Witnesses, I'm going to welcome and greet him, even though I don't want to. Oh, hello, who might you guys be?
We're members of the church, and we thought we would just stop by for a good old holiday greeting.
I haven't seen you at the church before.
We're new.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Would you mind if we come inside?
Sure, why not? From the church, any churchgoer is a friend of mine. Come on in.
Absolutely. I can say the same for you.
Well, all right.
Well, sir, may I use your restroom, please?
Yes, it's upstairs on the right.
Thank you.
Well,
you have a nice house.
Thank you. Oh, do you want some hot chocolate?
Sure. That sounds good.
All right. What about you, broski?
Name's Tim.
Well, okay, Tim. Do you want some hot chocolate, Mr. Tim?
No.
Oh, okay. I'll get on right away. Have some appetizers. What am I gonna do about those boys? Oh! Oh! Good Lord, Tim, you scared me.
Delicious holiday delight.
Here's yours.
Appreciate that, sir.
This was Tim, but I guess I'll have it, since he
doesn't
apparently want some.
You could absolutely do that. It's fine with me.
Okay, my question was, what's up with Tim?
He's just new.
Okay. Really? New at what?
His job. He's still coming to terms with it. It takes a while for it to settle in.
How long has he been in it? So what is his job?
I'll tell you if you tell me your relations to a man named Dylan Creed.
Oh, Dylan Creed! Man, yes, I know him so well. Yeah, I have a good relationship with him. Mm. Do you know him? How far do you guys go back?
I guess you can say since we were kids.
Since you were kids? Wow, me too. I wonder, do you think we ever met before?
I doubt it. So, do you have, like, a girlfriend or anything?
Oh, yes. Yes, I do. Yeah, we've been in a relationship for, like, 2 months now, thinking about popping the question. Oh, yeah.
That's wonderful. You got a good family, too?
Oh, yeah.
Nice family that cares about you, huh?
Yes,
definitely. Especially around this time of year.
Exactly.
Nice to have a nice family to go to.
Mm-hmm. Sure is.
It's horrible being lonely.
I have a girlfriend.
I'm just saying, in general, if you were lonely around this time, I bet it would be pretty awful.
Yeah. So what about you? What about your social life?
It's not that good, but we're not talking about me, we're talking about you, okay? So, when was the last time you spoke to Dylan Creed?
Dylan Creed? Actually, how about this? I won't tell you about Dylan Creed until you tell me what your job is.
Well, we kill people.
Come again? Did you just say...
Yeah, I did.
Okay, I get the joke, but what's your real job?
I kill people.
Okay, man, this isn't funny. What's your job? I mean, please,
My
if this is a joke...
My rapes people.
What?
We do drugs.
Come on, man, what?
We hide people. You kill them all.
If this is a joke, please tell me.
It's not a joke. We're killers. The whole lot of us. You have 3 killers in your home.
Okay. What do you really do?
We smuggle.
What?
We steal. Some of us are even good old sex offenders.
Oh, okay.
I'm not gonna tell you which ones.
Okay, that's right. Get out of this house.
I'm afraid that's not happening, buddy.
Dude.
Don't dude me.
What? No. Bible won't help me.
No, your God's not gonna.
Oh, hi, Tim. Okay. Siri, Dylan Creed. Why are you guys doing stuff like this?
It's not
what's happening.
Choice.
I'm gonna make a phone call.
No phone calls are gonna be made here right now. Just stop running. It's in your best interest.
Oh my goodness! Dylan! No!
You have the honors, boys.
What did he just say? What?
Time to see your true self.
No! Please! No!
Can't do this no more!
He's dead.
He's dead? Get out. Hey, wait. I need to get a note real quick.
Victoria Golden? Hello?
Roman's dead. Check your yard.
You not to F with me.
Roman!
Yeah, boss. I got him on my sight. Problem is, Snake Guys, he's fighting him and he in the way. Shoot him. Whatever you say.
This is it. This is where it all began. Who knew 16 years ago I'd kill someone from my own gang? And this stupid kid would come back and ruin my life. But now I see. You're just a pathetic little boy. Who never grew up. Cole, my boy, kill him.
Wait, Victoria Golden is your mom.
Victoria Golden?
Yeah. He took you from her when you were a kid.
You told me my mother abandoned me.
Listen.
That is what you told me.
Listen, this is not true. The man's trying to get into your head.
You lied to me. You lied to me!
Victoria Golden died in 1989. She had a 3-year-old child named Lawrence Golden. You were Lawrence Golden.
Yeah, you see, this is a bullshit. Listen, this is not true. The kid's trying to get in your head. Go. Now, you have been a major thorn in my side. So I'm gonna make this very hard for you. This is the letter your slut of a mother gave you. Your brother and your bastard father on Christmas Day 16 years ago. Every Christmas I read this heartfelt letter from your loving mother and laugh every time.
Oh! Let's see what you look like under that mask. That's for my father! That's for my mother! That's for Roman!
This is over today.
Nothing's ever.
What was that?
Nothing's ever.
You really think your father joined my gang because he was a nice guy?
He was joining your gang so he could buy a boat for us to go sailing!
He was not just a mean boy, he was my friend.
What are you talking about?
I'm saying your father wasn't a nice man. The nice guy you thought he was. He murdered, raped women, sold drugs, and pornography.
You're lying to me. You're lying! Do you know it's true?
What makes me believe you?
You stupid kid, what are you doing?
You know you're right. But it doesn't make you a better person.
No! Was thought to have children.
It made them soft and kind. All I have to do is push.
Good, do it. Be like your father.
I've been worshiping the wrong man.
My boy?
Shut up.
I could explain everything.
I don't know.